Going up live on the internet.
It'd be 20 past 10 in the evening. She's going to be watching. She'll watch this. She can't watch the commentary.
It is. Gave up. I've got my sparkly stick.
Are you right on?
Yeah. Yeah, it's better because I can stretch my leg out.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right on the elbow.
I've got to get up to do the reading.
Yes, it does. Did you see the Bailey's flowers?
Yeah. I didn't get a chance to look at the problems.
Yeah, I think they're going to put them on.
Kathleen gave me that this morning.
Yeah, I've got loads of tissues.
Thank you. to Kathleen, Moira, Margaret and Claire, and to their respective families, to Doreen's grandchildren and great-grandchildren, too many to name, but all very much loved. I'll welcome also and our thanks to members of the care team at Ashridge Port Care Home, who are also present with us today. And also, of course, welcome to parishioners from Bexhill who have joined us from this Mass. Thanks to our musicians who are adding so much to our celebration of Doreen's life and praying for her and composing her soul. And also, welcome anyone who may be joining us on the internet, on Facebook, our parish Facebook page, via the red flag just here in the front. In the waters of baptism, Doreen died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Doreen, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever.
Amen.
Let's be seated now at our reading and our song.
Thank you.
Please stand. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Yes, Lord, she said. I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into the world. The Gospel of the Lord. Especially needed rest by care due to those ulcers on her legs, she still wanted to remain connected to the body of Christ, sacramentally and socially. So we're grateful to Joe and to Kathleen for visiting Doreen at Ashwood Court. Doreen herself had been a dedicated home visitor in her own time, taking Holy Communion to the housebound, which is that primary apostolate of extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion. When I visited her to hear a confession and to fortify her with the sacraments of the sick from time to time, she wondered why she wasn't initially able to receive Holy Communion frequently. Sadly, over the last couple of years, there's remained times of intermittent restrictions as COVID, as we know, comes in waves, meaning she could not receive Holy Communion perhaps as frequently as she may have desired. And of course, Doreen came from that generation that had experienced hardship and always had such a positive attitude that all things were possible. So surely they are possible now. Yeah. Where there's a will, there's a way, as the saying goes. Being far removed from that time, it's perhaps hard for us to imagine what it was like growing up in the Welsh pit villages, or the courage that it takes to leave home and travel up to the Big Smoke, to London, only then to find yourself in the middle of a war. But is not the call to follow Jesus Christ the call to leave behind what we know and to push out into the deep, to seek the life of grace, which is nothing less than a share in the life of the Blessed Trinity in the communion of saints in heaven? Now, Doreen's journey of faith started in the Welsh chapel tradition. It was later transformed by her marriage to Jim, another great parishioner of this parish in years gone by. It's a relationship which played such a significant role in her own history of salvation. Marriage is a vocation which God called Doreen to. It was his chosen means to bring about her holiness, Jim's holiness, and the holiness of the family. Through Jim, Doreen was led to the fullness of communion with the Catholic Church, which developed into a strong and firm faith, which we commemorate, celebrate, and pray for today. This gift is not to be held onto. It needs to be shared. As has been said, the Catholic faith is only ever one generation away from dying out. So it is the vocation of a parent to hand on the faith to their children and to the grandchildren. I'm sure that Doreen's own children and grandchildren here present would have benefited immensely in seeing and experiencing her own joy of the gospel. As we know from the Apostle James, faith without good works is a dead faith. And many would have been inspired by Doreen's caring attitude, from her nursing background, taking in foster children, always putting the service of others ahead of her own needs and brothers. As John, who said to me at our meeting, Doreen has a spirit of fortitude. That's one of the gifts, actually, of the Holy Spirit that would have been given to Doreen at her confirmation when she was received into the church. So clearly she put it to good use. Eternal rest comes unto Doreen, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen.
Let us stand and
Dear brothers and sisters, Jesus says, if anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. And so we pray. And the response of the intercession, Lord, in your mercy, is hear our prayer. For Doreen, who in baptism was given a pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our sister Doreen, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and all those who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the family and friend of our sister Doreen, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord Jesus, who wept at the death of his own friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be reunited with our loved ones in heaven, and we remember especially Jim at this time also. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our
prayer. And we ask our parish patron, Our Lady of the Rosary, to pray with us and for us as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. And just a moment of silence, we just think of our own needs and intentions at this time. Almighty Father, we remain ambitious for the holy gifts, eternal life in the communion of saints, and so we ask you to hear and answer our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated once again. As we prepare the altar for the liturgy of the Eucharist, we'll sing our offertory hymn, making a chapter of peace. In your hymn books, it's 478. 478.
Thank you. though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed from ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We kneel now, if you are able to kneel, please sit. You are indeed holy, Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to you. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and whose command we celebrate those mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection, and take you from the dead. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving for this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body and one spirit of Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, your spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard, and of all the saints in whose constant intercession in your presence we rely on our unfailing God. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, and Richard our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people who have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all the children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Doreen, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with the Son in the death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who have listened to you at their passing from this life, give kind and we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow the world, all that is good.
You take away the sins of the world.
Let us stand and pray. The Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant us strengthened by it, our sister Doreen may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to be seated once again, and John is going to come and give the family tribute. Times were tough and didn't get any better as the industry grew drunk, prompting my
formative years took place against the background of the Second World War. She was evacuated with a storm and later to family in Wales, but returned where she was able to go to work. She worked in central London, even as the Wales fell, and even worked as a cabbie on the trolley buses. She met my dad at a roller skating rink, and the rest, as I say, is history. But home life had been difficult when she was growing up, and it affected her and her self-confidence. This, alongside the uncertainty and displacement which she had experienced, became a challenge for her. But it was a challenge that she met with its determination to ensure that we, and her kids, could always rely on having the love and stability in their lives that we need. I don't think it was always easy for her. She had to work at it. She failed, reflected, and tried again. And over time she struggled, but her faith, determination, and the love and support of my dad helped her through those difficult times, she told me. They were an amazing team. Together they raised a family, educated us well, and sent us up to make a difference in the world. She made sure that we had the opportunities that they didn't have, and most importantly, turned out that we always struck team and struck faith. Just a few of my achievements. We heard earlier in the offering hymn the words of St. Francis in the hymn Anguish and the Real Peace. Our master, from my name, not so much said to be consoled. Not so much seek to be understood as to understand, and not so much seek to be loved as to love. For it is in the giving that we receive, it is in the pardoning that we are pardoned. For me, my mum exemplified those ideals in the way that she helped us support other people. Thinking about the amazing changes in the world during the 96 years, looking at what she did for an overcome, like so many other generations, and how she dealt with those challenges was amazing. She certainly kept up with technology and kept her mind active, bringing her iPad to play mahjong, catching up with everybody on Facebook and putting a lol next to stuff, watching Mass from the comfort of her own chair. She really kept up with things. Now, not everything in the long run went with her approval, and she definitely let me know. One of her quotes was, come dancing. It's not come dancing, that's not dancing, joy rating, I call it. Just one example. But her readiness to laugh and see the lighter side and find fun was a joy and made love better. Her toughness and determination has been demonstrated in the rest of the years as she dealt with the succession of injuries and infirmities. Quite how she acted for the treatment of the ulcers is beyond me. The pain she endured and the incredible quantities of medication it took to get through would have felt most of us. They make them tough, these baby girls. At this point, I'd also like to mention the staff at Ashley's Resort, some of here today, and thank them for their hard work and care for mum. Not only did their diligence and professionalism get mum through that particularly tough patch, they were really right through to the last. Thank you. But finally, as sad as we are today, we should be comfortably knowing when it was mum's time, that she is ready to be reunited with her loved ones and will be waiting for us when our time comes too. We can bring to mind our memories of happy times when we need to and always hold her in our hearts. And if we've been gifted a fraction of her determination and courage, use her achievements and her example to guide us through our own challenges.
to the final commendation. Our sister Doreen has fallen asleep in Christ, confident in our hope of eternal life. Let us commend her to the loving mercy of our Father, and let our prayers go with her. Doreen was adopted as God's daughter and was nourished at the table of the Lord. May she now inherit the promise of eternal life and take her place at the table of God's children in heaven. So, in a moment, I'm going to once again sprinkle Doreen's coffin with holy water, a reminder of her baptism when she became a new creation in Christ. I'm also going to incense her coffin as an ancient mark of respect. It's a reminder that the body or her ashes need a resting place as we await the resurrection of the body on the last day. Incense is a sign of our prayers rising to heaven on Doreen's behalf. It's the fragrance of Christ who now comes with his angels to greet her.
Thank you.